You are watching the South African Morning. Let's head on to our book review this week. We are discussing Thamsanqa Malinga's book titled Blame Me on Apartheid. The book looks at the origins of townships and how their existence under current conditions continues the legacy of apartheid. Malinga fuses academic thought with personal reflections to encourage debate about generational pain and present-day hardships. The author joins us live now in studio to discuss the book. Thank you so much for stopping by, Thamsanqa. So this book looks at the origins of our townships, but not only that, there's also a major focus on the legacy that apartheid has left behind. Why was it so important for you to pen this book?
Thanks, Nandi. What was important for me was I wanted to start contributing to the history of South Africa. You know, it's been said that when up until lions have their own storytellers, yeah, the story of the hunt will always glorify the hunter. So I felt that I needed to at least leave a legacy that I have contributed to telling the story of South Africa as I have seen it. Most of our history has been chronicled either by white academics, white scholars, you know, white writers, and dating back to the colonial era. So we haven't even started telling stories from our own perspective. So the Blame on Apartheid was then a platform for me to say, let me contribute to the story, to the history of South Africa in a way.
Yeah, and that is what I found quite wonderful about this book, is the fact that you are drawing from some of your own experiences, having lived in a number of townships and having dealt with some of the conditions. What are some of the experiences that you've drawn on when writing this book?
Well, some of the experiences that I've drawn on is the issue of education, for example. I write about how education has been structured in the township. You know, before I came on and before I came on air, I remember an incident where a colleague of mine, a friend of mine, dropped out of high school because the teacher kept on mocking him, you know, yeah, saying, "You're busy scratching your beard whilst your peers are university or your peers are working." The guy dropped out, didn't even get to grade 12. So I write about those type of things to say the education that was created from the colonial era to apartheid was not meant to actually free us, but it was education that also was oppressing us to an extent that you found people either dropping out or you found people without having proper education. So I drew on those experiences. I drew on an experience, I write about an experience when I was attending school in a town of called Piet Retief,
yeah,
in Mpumalanga, you know, where we had to do gardening. And as part of that, I saw among my peers, I was around 11 years old, I saw around my peers how those who were good at gardening, you know, would after school go on to the town, the yeah, center, you know, because we were in the township, which I call the periphery. They went on to the town, to the towns to seek work as garden boys at the age of 11.
Wow.
You know, so I write about those things to say it's the education was not that good. It just made us, it conditioned us to be laborers.
Yeah. You know? And just very quickly, you also talk about the romanticizing of township life. And I want you to talk to me very quickly about what that means, because it comes with some ironies, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. You know, we always like to say, I come from the hood.
Yeah.
You know? Artists have sang about, I come from the ghetto, you know, Pumezwale Mabodini, and all of that. But the reality is that those places, you know, we are romanticizing them, but they were meant to actually break us. You know, it's yeah, now we talk about them as if, you know, it's a place that we need to be proud of. The reality of this is that it's not a place to be proud of.
Yeah.
You know, it's a place that was created for us to sit there and only go out when we go out of the township to go into the center where we need to ply our labor, you know. But now we romanticize it. We advocate Ngalwana, who writes the prologue, writes about people now talking about the township economy. You know, we're now romanticizing a township economy as if we now we're talking about the township economy, yeah. It's supposed to be an economy on its own outside of the broader South African economy, you know, so we romanticize those things. Yeah. Why are we calling it the township economy? Why is it not the South African economy?
Yeah. Very important questions raised there. Thank you so much for stopping by. Thamsanqa Malinga, author of Blame Me on Apartheid.